Well, for more on oil, we are joined by Juan Jose Suarez Coppel. He's the CEO of Mexico's state-owned oil company, Pemex. Pemex exports more oil to the United States than any Middle East country. It is Latin America's largest oil producer. Juan Suarez, thank you very much for joining us. We appreciate it for this exclusive interview. Now, first off, with oil prices going up and up, are you planning on increasing your output at all?
Thank you for having me with you, Betty. Good morning. No, we're right now we're producing at our practical full capacity. We are increasing our production from last year because of some declines that we suffer over the last several years. But right now we are producing at maximum capacity, but we expect to increase production during this year and in the near future.
You do plan on increasing production?
Yes, out of new developments of fields.
Is there, though, at some price point, though, with oil, if it reaches 120, 130, where you're going to look to try to increase, even though you're at a maximum capacity, but are you going to try to increase some production at a certain price in oil?
What we're trying to do now is to develop, to increase our capacity to produce. Increasing the full capacity means that we don't have any spare capacity right now. What we're actually doing today in Houston is announcing a new round of contracting for development of mature fields in Mexico. We believe that this is going to have a very significant impact on our capacity to produce more oil.
Let's talk a little bit about that, Juan Suarez, because I know that that has been a subject of much debate in Mexico about these contracts and bringing in private investment to develop some of these oil fields. First off, how much investment are you looking for in these oil projects?
Well, this first round is comprises of three blocks. These three blocks are producing right now around 15,000 barrels per day. We plan to increase it to over 55,000 barrels a day. These three blocks will imply an investment in the order of $700 million over 20 years or so. But this is the first round. There is a lot of potential to increase production from mature fields in Mexico. There's a lot of potential to increase production in other complex fields that we haven't developed in the past in Mexico. That's why we are trying to increase our execution capabilities by having these service contracts to develop our fields.
And the reason why I mentioned that, you know, this has been the subject of much debate in Mexico is because I know these are obviously national assets, and there's been some concern about foreign companies coming in and partnering on these projects. Who do you expect could come in? What foreign oil companies may come in and partner with you?
Well, we have a variety of different fields in Mexico, and that's precisely why we need to spend our execution capabilities and our technical capabilities in some of these fields. So this first round is mature fields. We will be looking for, or we will expect interest from companies that have experience in mature fields, which, as you know, are operations that have very very flexible operation and are very usually small, independent upstream companies. Mm-hmm. In the future, we tend to keep on working on mature fields, okay, on some complex fields that we have, but then we also plan to use these contracts, which are, again, service contracts, for developing our deep water potential. There, the profile of the companies that we expect to be interested,
right,
changes to companies more focused on deep waters.
Okay, and maybe some of the foreign companies then. How high do you expect the price of oil to go? Do you have any idea?
Well, of course, it depends a lot on the political developments. No? So if there is a stabilization, then we will expect it to go down to around where it was before. That said, we expect a medium long-term trend upwards. No? So right now what we're seeing is this volatility caused by obviously political considerations, and as such, short term, it depends on what happened in the development of these political situations.
Okay, we're going to leave it there, but thank you. Really appreciate it. Juan José Suarez Coppel, who is the CEO of Pemex, a state-owned monopoly there in Mexico.